It does happen, so do bear with me. I couldn't get the vocals and everything. So let's just see how that works now. Let us see that you can hear me. I do apologize for that. I was talking away and I realized, whoa, something is happening. Nobody can hear me. So we are just testing everything out. Is that my call? It's not the wrong one. Properties, give me a minute. Okay, I think, is that correct? Yeah, I think that's correct. Let me just check everything here. So good afternoon. Welcome to Season AY, the platform where we speak to you. Those of you on TikTok, do bear with me. There is a sort of issue in terms of the audio. And we're trying to iron that out before we proceed with the discussion proper. So do bear with me. It's not a rush thing. We just have to make sure that we get everything right. I think, yeah, that's it. I think we've solved that problem. Let me just make sure that you can hear me loud and clear. Okay, I think you can hear me loud and clear. So let me just make sure I bring this. So let's just make sure that everything is as it should and it's not going to give us any blowback or anything like that. So good afternoon and welcome to Season AY, the platform where we speak through the power. Thank you, Tycoon, Larry, NWD123, and those of you who are on TikTok, thank you very much. This broadcast is about Nigeria. For those of you who are on TikTok, so you may be wondering, if you are not Nigerian, you may not follow, but we are just here to highlight the concerns of the people, and we're going to try as much as possible to talk about the concerns. Basically, people who voted for Tinubu are really up in arms now. We're not laughing about it. We're just saying that's the reality on ground. People are suffering and people are saying the government is not helping them and they really need the government help right now. So there is hunger in the land. That's what we're saying. In effect, there is hunger in the land. There is hunger in the land. And people are really, voicing their concerns. The market women in various states have been coming out and complaining that they are suffering too much. They can't feed their children. Many of them, they are single moms. Their husband has passed away. Hi to Michael. Let me just say hi. I'll say hi to everybody on TikTok. You're watching Season AY, the platform where we speak truth to power. We may touch on a wider issue of the conflict going on in various places as we go along, but we always want to start off with what is going on ground in Nigeria. Please do share this broadcast. You are, of course, watching Season AY, the platform where we speak truth to power. I want to take this opportunity to urge you all, if you are joining us for the first time and you haven't subscribed to Season AY, please go ahead and do so on YouTube. This program will be broadcasted and we streamed on YouTube directly afterwards. So we may have some interaction going on TikTok later on. David Kayode, welcome on board, my brother. So I'm going to say Ola Oforiata, welcome on board. I'm going to say as many hellos as possible. I will endeavor to try and do more broadcasts, but sometimes it is out of my hands sometimes. What we want to do today is talk about the concerns of the people. And as it says on the broadcast, you can see it on the screen, Tinubu government has failed us. So before I go into that now, I want us all to really be aware of something. And this is for those of you who are going to be supporting, who know about Nigeria. I will always start off with this comment. It's on the screen. Those of you who are watching us on Facebook right now, it is on the screen. The words you see there, we're going to read that word for word. I want you to begin to familiarize yourself with those words in English and in your local language. Now, it states on the screen, you can see it. It is hereby accordingly declared that A, sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria, from whom the government, through this constitution, derives all its powers and authority. And there will be, I will make that clear to you later on, why those words are important, why we need to really state those words. Again, Section 14.2c states, the participation by the people in the government shall be ensured in accordance with the provisions of this constitution. Now, I'm putting that on the screen permanently. And there's a reason why we are putting it on there. We are putting it on because we want you to become, to understand that whatever it is you want from the government right now, it is important to understand that you will not get. Let me say that again. Whatever it is you want from the Nigerian government right now, and incidentally, it doesn't matter which government is in place. Tinubu, Peter Obi, Atiku, you won't get anything because the system is deeply flawed. But before I go too far ahead into the explanation, let us listen to the man who is complaining, and he said, Tinubu government has failed us. So we're going to listen to him now. Let's listen. And he speaks in Yoruba. I will endeavor to translate it into English. Here we go.
Tiwadoju e bayi o. Igba wa logo ni sele lorede Nigeria. Ilu isumi o. In fact, e wo gogo e tiwadogun. Oro ti awolowo so fun wa olo ma bere si ni sele. Ko si ba ti revolution ni sele lorede Nigeria. Ta ni ja funra wa. Awolowo ti so pa ma ja funra wa lorede Nigeria ni o. Mi o si leko lati kan bi ose meji seyin. Mo se se dese ko ba nsin ni mo da gege ki ra top taste bread di top taste ti mo ra ni 1002 tele 1005 ni mo ba ba nsin o lele yo mo de ti promise awon mo mi pe ma ba won ra wale be ko se ma ra igba la fe bo loko eru ijoba Tinubu ko favor anybody everybody pariwo awon loja gan pariwo won le sun won le wo won lawon amo ya won to ti ku e tun won ti oja won loju e la san won paro titi won la diwo fun yin awon ibo wa fun se e nsin won pe ko tan e beyin lo kan se ba se ma ba lo leleyi ijoba Tinubu ara ni awon mekunu iya nje wa Nigeria mo ri se lo le ba nsin ni o moto gan won pe sango fun mi ni 800 naira e ri ori ni mo wa bayi o osowo moto se ba se ma ba lo leleyi ijoba Tinubu iya nje awon eyan erojo ola e mojo tayin go ku Tinubu ati gogo e ijoba te se ijoba ofole wa lori iya te fi nje wa ti to kilo de ijoba be kunu e fi aje wa eyin re o olorun re o e wan campaign were ti oni tumo e kowo je e se gogo e fi tu ara yin se e wo ta o me kunu se ba se ma ma ba lo leleyi pelu ogun olorun gogo eyin to n da ijoba Nigeria ru on va passer won je aisan ti pa wo ka ilo ma je ti pelu ogun olohun pelu edu okan mo fi soro inu mi odun rara bread 1005 re top taste 1005 e ma sofo ni eyin joba wa.
So basically what the man was saying, he was complaining, just to say it in English, the man is complaining that there is hunger in the land, that people are suffering, that it is unjust that they cannot afford to buy meals, just simple food. Transport fare to Sango from Lagos is 800 naira, something he can't afford. So he's having to walk. Now, that is just one person that you're hearing. There are many, many more who are complaining about the fact that things are tough. And yes, we can sort of certainly say, okay, Tinubu government has only been there for a few months, so give it time. But what the people are saying is that they voted and believing that Tinubu would help the masses. That is what they believed. That is why many of them supposedly voted for the government. They believed in Tinubu. Now, many people feel shortchanged. Many people, as a result, they have felt shortchanged by the current government. And that is what you are seeing displayed on the screen and in the comments made by people. Now, what I'm here to say to you all is that it doesn't, this goes deeper than Tinubu. This goes deeper than any one person. This goes to the heart of the entire system. The entire system is totally flawed. And until we address that issue, nothing will change. I want you all to please bear something in mind. I'm going to play the next video. Please, begging your government to do something for you is like talking to people who are hard of hearing. I'm going to say that again. begging your government to come up and do anything to alleviate your pains and your discomfort and your impoverishment is talking to people with deaf ears. They will not be able to solve your problem. Fact. I'm not here to try and abuse. I think we need to understand that fact. Because if you are hoping, and that is why I'm saying to you, all of you going to churches and mosques to pray for good governance, to pray that the government does what it needs to do, it is a wasted energy. I'm sorry to say it. It is a wasted energy. And until we begin to change that mindset, that's why we are here on Citizenewa, the platform where we speak truth to power. We don't believe in telling you lies. We tell you like it is. We come on and we tell you like it is. We don't need many followers. We're not interested in that. We are trying to pass out a message to you all. And it starts with you and I, as citizens, as sovereigns, beginning to exercise the powers. Remember, I read to you section 14.2a that talks about sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria, from whom the government, through this constitution, derives all its powers and authority. Well, that's you are the sovereign. You watching me, or that will watch me later on, you are the sovereign. And you have the powers that the government derives to govern you collectively in each of your community as a local government. You all have the powers to hold your governors to account. What has been missing, however, is that since 1999, the government, successive governments, have never made you aware of what you're seeing on the screen right now. They have never made you aware of those words. And I put it on there so that you can see those words and begin to learn it and share it in your community. I'm going to do the same thing in Yoruba as well and make sure that those words are on the screen for Yoruba people. And also, if you do have those words in, I'll try and do it in Igbo and in Hausa language as we go along at some point. But I'm not, for now, we just need to start with the English version of it first. So we need to really understand that all these prayers and all this begging of those in government, it's going to fall on deaf ears. They are hard of hearing. It is as simple as that. They are hard of hearing. Even if they wanted to, the system that is operated, they will not do anything. All they will come to you is to say, let us pray, like they do. They will say, go to church and pray. They will say, go to the mosque and pray. They will call the imams and the pastors to a meeting. Please encourage the people to go and pray. Let them go and pray. And what they are doing is, once you start praying, they are giving you a drug. They are giving you a drug. And that drug is something that I like to term, you've had this saying before, opium of the mind. They say religion is what? Is an opium of the mind. That is what is happening. We need to break that cycle of trusting in the very people who are failing us in government. And the only way we can do that is to become active participants in our governance, which section 14.2c states, and I'm going to state it here again. It states, the participation by the people in their government shall be ensured in accordance with the provisions of this constitution. That is what is showing you on the screen. Unless and until we, the people, begin to actively participate in our governance using the powers of sovereignty, because they derive the powers and authority from us, using those powers, as stated in the constitution, nothing will change. Nothing will change. I am here to tell you that everything that we're suffering from, the religious intolerance, the oppressions, the killings and abductions, the lack of infrastructure, it all boils down to the fact that we have not been able to consistently and actively on a daily basis participate in our governance. Those of you on TikTok, welcome on board. To get a better experience, you can join us on Facebook. And of course, don't forget, those of you watching on both platforms, we really do need your support in growing our platform on YouTube. We need that platform to grow, because this is a kind of information that we want our people to have at their fingertips. we need to change the mindset of our people. It is now about the mindset of our people that we are here to try and correct, to change. And if you keep doing the same thing, I am here to tell you that going to a church or to a mosque to pray for good governance, for the government to listen to your concerns, is wasting your energy. Going to any church or any mosque to pray and believe that that will solve your problems is a waste of your energy. Please take this on board. I need us all to understand the only way we can make that change that we all want is to begin to actively participate in our governance. On this platform, Citizen AY, the platform where we speak truth to power, we are willing to talk you through that process on ground. This is a process that has to happen within each and every community, from the villages, into the hamlets, into the towns and cities. This is what must happen. Instead of you wasting your energy going to any church and any mosque, and believe me, the churches and the mosque, they are being paid by the government. You suddenly see, have you asked yourself how somebody will suddenly open a church and then suddenly the church becomes a mega church? Somebody, they got money and they build a church and they make it nice and they have water and they have light and they have everything in the church. But your community doesn't have water and light. Have you wondered about that? Well, let me tell you a little secret. You may be aware. You may not be aware. The government work closely with the religious people, Christians and Muslims, to ensure that the mind of the people is occupied with what is effectively a routine. Because religion, as practiced, is simply a routine. It's a quotidian. You do the same thing over and over and over and over. The government reminds, they tell you. You see, the pastor and the imam will say, let us pray for our government. Let us pray for a better Nigeria. Let us pray. But what should be happening is that we, the people, should be saying, no, we don't need prayer. We need to know where the money that you are getting on a monthly basis, we need to know where it's going, because we are the sovereigns. Because it states, again, on the screen, you can see it. Those of you who are on TikTok, you can see, you will get a better experience if you join us on Facebook, because Citizen AY is on Facebook. Just type in Citizen AY, you see it on there. And we will stream it later on YouTube. But of course, I take this opportunity to ask us all, if you haven't subscribed to Citizen AY on YouTube, please go ahead and subscribe. We really need your support in growing that platform. We don't know what is happening with Facebook at the minute. There seems to be some sort of things whereby Facebook are really depressing the numbers. We'll spend some time on here. I'm going to try and build that up again and see what happens. But Facebook, in their infinite wisdom, sees it fit. For me, as a platform that has over 119,000 followers, that only 5 or people or so are watching us on Facebook live right now. But that's not a problem. We will continue with the message. Our message is to wake our people up. That is what we are here for. Please do not misunderstand me. The fact that I'm talking about that you need to participate in your governance doesn't mean I have any confidence in Nigerian government. It's not going to work. It isn't. But what we are going to do is beginning to take part in that process. It will open the door for us to go for self-determination. That is where we need to be. I'm very, very clear about where I'm going. I'm very, very clear in my mind about the objective, the aims and the objectives that we need to achieve. Our people do not know that they have been lied to by the government. And our job on Citizen AY, the platform where we speak to the power, is to make you aware of the lies that you've been told and the fact that they've hidden this from you. But before I proceed, let us watch the next video where the second man talks about the same thing. He's an APC supporter and he says the same thing in English. So let us hear what he's saying here. Give me a minute. You will see it come up. I want you to see and understand and comprehend. Because you need to get an understanding. Anyway, I'll explain why I use those words. You need to really see and understand what is really happening and how we can begin to address the issues. But we first need to hear from the very people that were telling us, oh, Tinubu is the man that can do it and all of that. And I'm not here to accuse, to ridicule anybody or any government. That's not what I'm doing. I just want us to know that it doesn't matter. This is beyond Tinubu. It doesn't matter what government that you put in. Sadi kings. We're talking about Yoruba and Nigeria issues now. So Sadi king, you will not be able to participate in that. So I'm going to leave that. So thank you very much for that. That's from TikTok. But we're talking about Nigeria, and you will not fully understand the dynamics of what we're saying in terms of the people saying that the government has failed them. But if people threw an invite, if you're a Yoruba person or an Igbo man or Nigerian, and you can throw us an invite, then of course, I'm happy to bring you on board and we can talk about it. Now, again, I'm going to switch this on and hopefully you will hear something. Let us hear the man now say what he's saying about the Tinubu government. And he's actually begging for help because he's facing medical health issues. So let's hear what he has to say. Now let's listen.
The president of Nigeria, the president-elect, by the grace of the president-elect.
A few moments later.
So, this, Nigeria government, you people should come to our rescue. For we with debt, asthmatic patients, we say we cannot afford this. You people need to call this company back, called GSK. Before, this teletize, for we with debt asthma for this Nigeria. This teletize, this is about 8,000 plus. But because this company don't pack them up for Nigeria, look at now, I'm at the pharmacy. Plenty, missing this, 52,500. Abba. Betuli Ela. Betuli Ela, where would they buy 2,000 before? Because this company, where the producer for Nigeria don't come out. Now, Betuli Ela don't enter 8,500 for Nigeria. Please, Nigeria government, you people should come to our rescue. For we will debt asthmatic patients, where we say we cannot afford this. I'm of my salary, 45,000 Naira. And me now, I must be taking this. Federal government, you people have to come to our rescue. Please, on behalf of all the people that get asthma, please, you people have to come for this. Please, I am begging. Because without we taking this, if we can't beat, we'll be dying. Anyhow, asthmatic people will die. But I pray that should not happen in Nigeria. Please.
So basically, he was a man that was clearly supporting Tinubu. And there's nothing wrong in supporting any of the parties, by the way. You have to support some kind of party. Which party? You have to support it. I understand that. The point I'm making is that even the supporters of this government realize that there's a problem because now his health concerns are not being addressed. And I want to state at this point, specifically on the health concerns, I want to make you aware of something. I don't know if I've done it before. Let's see if I can find it. Okay, you can't see that. Okay. There is a section under section 17.3D. It says that the state shall direct its policy towards ensuring that there are adequate medical and health facilities for all. Section 17.3D. Please go and look at that. I'll see if I can bring it up on the screen or I'll bring it up later on. But I want you to remember those words. Please quote me. Section 17.3. It states, the state shall direct its policy towards ensuring that there are adequate medical and health facilities for all. Now, based on him requiring for them to make the medicines cheaper, what should be happening is that we should be reminding them that they need to comply with the Constitution because the Constitution says that they need to provide medical care for all. They didn't say the people have to pay for it. They said the government have to provide adequate medical and health facilities for all. But because we are not following or reading that constitution and referring to it when we speak to those in government, we are not exercising our powers of sovereignty. That's the point that I've been making. And what are the powers of sovereignty? It's on the screen right there. It states, it is hereby accordingly declared that, 14.2a, sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria, from whom the government, through this constitution, derives all its powers and authority. That's what it states. So, who has those powers? The sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria. Who are those people? It's you and I. We need to teach our people in our communities to know those powers. And that is why we've embarked on a program. Right now, we've translated large sections, up to section 53 of the Nigerian Constitution. It's been translated into Yoruba language. So you will hear those words in Yoruba. So for example, 14-2A states in Yoruba language, Ijoba deti awon eniyan Nigeria, lati odo ni tijoba, nipa se ofin orilede n gba gbogbo agbara ati ase re. So in simple terms, it's saying to the people, sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria, from whom the government, through this constitution, derives all its powers and authority. Let me greet everybody who's watching me on Facebook. Avram James, thank you very much. Samson Samkoza, thank you very much. Yeyeto Otuba Adegbenigbe, thank you. Pastor Olusegun Opeyemi, thank you. Muritala Gbadamosi, thank you. Aguilar and Tempsi, good afternoon, welcome. Mogba Omoba, thank you. Ada Doris, welcome. Malomo Ajibola, thank you. Mickey Muya, thank you very much. For those of you who have been following the broadcast, continue to share the broadcast. We appreciate each and every one of you. The topic today is the people have said, the citizens who are suffering saying the government have failed them. And I'm here to say that we should not expect any help from those in government, because we have not been taught how to participate in governance by the same people. And they know that there are certain laws, that powers that we possess as citizens. Okereke AK, thank you very much. Welcome on, and thank you for joining us. Please do give us a thumbs up and like, and if like the broadcast, to make it grow, reach more people. So please help us like the broadcast, you know, give us some likes and some stars. We welcome that. So hit the like button, help us grow the platform. You know, we really appreciate each and every one of you as you are coming in. It is of immense importance, and we need to really, we thank you all for your belief and trust in our platform. Don't forget, go ahead and subscribe to Citizen Ewa on YouTube. Hit the notification button, give us thumbs up. So let's do this way. So subscribe to Citizen Ewa on YouTube, hit the notification button, give us thumbs up. As stated before, as we speak right now, we have over 100,000 followers on Facebook. We are grateful for those of you following us. Our notifications has been switched off by Facebook. Doesn't matter. We will come out as often as we can. And we are in discussions with Facebook to remove all of the things that they've put in, the restrictions they place on the platform, because that is affecting our reach. It is doing so. And we are complying with the laws of Facebook on a daily basis. We are reviewing and checking, ensuring that we comply. For example, you will never see me post a video whereby I just post a simple video and somebody else is talking. In all our videos that you will see on the broadcast, we are always in it. And the videos we'll show will be to illustrate a particular point and emphasize certain things, such as you're seeing that we're doing right now on Facebook. So we are in discussions with them, and they're telling us, for the past 2 months now, it's been just back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. But we won't relent. But back to the central issue of what we're saying. Keep in mind, I said it. Under Section 17.3, it states, the state shall direct its policy towards ensuring that there are adequate, D of the Nigerian Constitution, there are adequate medical and health facilities for all. So this man that you see on the screen, that's an APC supporter, I don't even think he knows what I just read. He's not aware that he has the power to mandate the government to provide medical health for him. Not begging. He's begging because he doesn't know these powers. And that's why we're encouraging all of us now to begin to really know the Constitution of Nigeria. We will need that information to take the next step that we need to take, which is to go for self-determination. Without knowing what is in the Constitution, we can't change the Constitution. That is what I am putting before each and every one of us. I hope this is making sense. I hope this is making sense. Now, what I want us to really home in on now is that the churches and the mosques, they are using it to close your eyes. The churches and the mosques in Nigeria, I am categorically telling you that their job is to distract the people from ever holding those in office to account. They give the churches and the mosques money. They have a direct line. They have a direct line. Those mosques and the churches have a direct line to the government. And they make sure. Uche Nwoko, thank you very much for joining us. Oluwaseun Oba Wonwo, thank you very much for joining us. They make sure that the religious houses, they are making so much noise that we, the people, are unable to actually separate ourselves and focus on what we need, which are infrastructure, safety, security, holding our government to account, accountability, being able to participate in the process of governance, which I am showing you, which you see on the screen. 42C states, again, I'm going to read that to you. The participation by the people in the government shall be ensured in accordance with the provisions of this constitution. What that means, David Ayodemi, welcome. Ayodeoni, welcome on board. You're watching us on TikTok. Thank you for joining us. You can see behind me, the government, Tinubu government, has failed us. That is what the people are saying. It's not what I'm saying. It's what the people who are suffering on a daily basis, who are not able to get food, who are not able to get transport or petrol or live on or have electricity in their homes or have government provide the good roads for them, who are suffering on a daily basis. They are saying the government has failed them. And that is their reality. Now, the government has been using for many, many years the religions of Islam and Christianity to close your eyes. And we're coming on the platform now to make you aware that is what has been done to you over the years. And we are going to tell you, we've been telling you how they do that. They tell you to go to pray. They have prayer sessions. But all of those prayers, do you know that those pastors, many of the big pastors that you know of now, the government give them money. The money that they have been used to fix your road, to fix your water, to fix your light, to fix your schools, to fix your healthcare, to provide proper palliatives. That money, yes. Instead of using that, the government will take some of it, give to a pastor. That is why you see pastors. It's big business. It's big business because the government is giving them funding. And imams is giving them big money. You know, it's big business for them. Because the government used them to close your minds. Once you start talking about your suffering, they get into your church. The church will even give you some food. Some of you will know in the churches, when you go to, they will give you some food in there. Because they want you to know, they want you to come back to that church. So the salvation that you be, the feeling of support that you should be getting from the government now comes from the hand of the churches and the mosque. That the government has paid money to keep your eyes closed and from ever holding them to account. I keep telling you, on the screen, you have the powers that you possess as citizens. It states, 14.2a, sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria, from whom the government, through this constitution, derives all its powers and authority. Now, unless and until we begin to use those powers collectively in our community, nothing is going to change. More and more people will die. Now, many people are afraid. They say, I get one house. I get one by child. Mama there for house. Papa there for house. Fella said it. Rest in peace, fella. So, policeman go slap your face, you know, go talk. I'm a man go weep. Your yash, you go, they look like donkey. You know, and so on and so forth. That is what's happening. Many people are saying, we can't challenge the government. I can't say anything. And whilst you are being afraid, many are dying. People are saying, women and a lot of people are saying, people are literally dying. They are literally dying on a daily basis of hunger. So when you say, we cannot take on the government, we will not participate, we don't know, you are putting yourself in danger. You are going to die in any case. If you speak the truth, you will die. If you stay silent, you will die. Isn't it better to speak up? At least you would have spoken up. That is the point that we are making now. We need everybody to understand, because people are saying, oh, the government, they will bring this, they will bring some money and buy some of us. The longer you continue to believe that you are powerless, and the government wants you to believe, they want you to believe that you are powerless. They want you to think that all the powers they possess. But I'm here to tell you, it says so on the book that you see on there, on the screen. Sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria, from whom the government, through this constitution, derives all its powers and authority. The sad part is that they have conditioned our mind using religion for many years. I went to churches on Sundays. I went to miracle gospel meetings, miracles, where the pastor or the whatever, the healer will come and talk to everybody, and the people will put their hands up and they say, yes, I claim it. And they say they are healed. They will walk 5 minutes. And then when they finish walking for just 5 minutes down the road, whatever pains and sufferings they have is still with them. It's all trickery. It is all trickery. And we've fallen for that over the years, over and over and over and over and over. And the reason why we've fallen for it for 24 years is because the government never once told us about the powers that you see on the screen. So we are providing those powers, and we need you to share it. Here is where you come in. Here is where you come in. You need to go, as you're watching us now on Facebook, share this with your family and friends. You see, you can take a screenshot of what is on the screen right there. And what you see on there, those words that you see, they are powerful words. But they cannot, the real power is when we begin to use those words within each and every community to begin to hold those we elect into office to account. So how do we use those powers? Well, let me tell you. What we do is this. We need to teach our family in their local languages. You heard me say it before. The Constitution, Section 14.2 and 14.2c. In our local language. Let me say it briefly for Yoruba people. So you are, those are following me. 14.2a states, Ijoba je ti awon eniyan Nigeria lati odo niti joba nipase ofin orilede ngba gbogbo agbara ati ase re. We need our people to understand that in their own local languages, particularly our market women, our farmers, vulcanizers, hairdressers, buka owners, street hawkers, clothes makers. Everybody needs to know that constitution in their local language. That has been the missing part of the jigsaw. The constitution was written in English, and what that has done, the constitution has separated itself from the people. Star, I'm not quite sure who Star is. That's somebody else. I'm not quite sure. That's into something else. Oh no, that's somebody else. I'm not. I thank you very much for those of you who are on TikTok. This is about Nigeria, and you can see behind me, Tinubu government has failed us, and that is what the people are saying. So let us proceed. So what we need our people to do is to begin to use those powers. Again, I read it in Yoruba. Ijoba je ti awon eniyan Nigeria lati odo niti joba nipase ofin orilede ngba gbogbo agbara ati ase re. That's in Yoruba. We need to tell our communities about this in their language so they know the powers they possess. The second part of it, what you see on the screen again, 14.2c, the participation by the people in the government shall be ensured in accordance with the provisions of this constitution. In Yoruba, it states, ikopa awon eniyan ninu ijoba gbodo ri daju ni ibamu pelu awon ofin orilede. Please, those of you who are watching this, share the broadcast. Share as many times as possible, because we need to, our mindset has been corrupted, we've been mentally enslaved by the religions of Christianity and Islam. I kid you not. Without many of us, if you notice, if you do not go to church 1 week, your body will feel different. Or go to a mosque and pray 5 times a day, your body will feel different. Because you've been conditioned to believe that for you to be okay, you need to be in that church, you need to be in that mosque. That is why we say the religion is an opium of the mind. They have literally made sure that your life, your psychological self depends on going to that location, that church, that mosque, for you to feel better. But are you really feeling better? How can you feel better when your roads are not fixed? How can you feel better when the food that you're going to pay for to feed your child is expensive. How can you feel better when the school fees that you have to pay for your schools, you have to pay in dollars? How can you feel better when there is no health care for you? How can you feel better? So you see now that the religions, they are there to trick your mind to accept what is totally unacceptable, which is the injustice that we are facing collectively on a daily basis. That is why the only option that we have now, each and every one of us, the only option that we have left now is to participate in our governance using the powers that you see on the screen. Let me say this. We have translated the Nigerian constitution, like I said earlier on, into Yoruba up to section 53, and it's on Citizen AY, www.citizenay.org. Go to the website. You will see a section that calls that says Iwe Ofin 1999 Niede Yoruba. Click on that. You will have all of the powerful sections of the constitution already for you to read in your local language, in your communities. Now, this is a job for all of us collectively. No one person. This is not a job for one person. It's not a job for Citizen AY alone. It is for all of us. And we need to participate in that process. Those of you who are on Citizen AY Constitutional Awareness Action Group, I want to greet you all because this is streaming directly in their live. Do come in and make a comment if you would like to. We appreciate that. Like I said, I know Facebook are making things very difficult, but we are not. That's not the object of what we are. We are not really concerned. Like I said, I'm going to restream this immediately after this on YouTube. But what I want us all to do is to understand that every day that we go to a church, every day that we go to a mosque, it is taken away from the collective effort that we could be using to ask the government, to demand from the government to be accountable as to where the funds that they receive on a monthly basis from the sale of oil, from the sale of from VAT, from all the from foreign income reserves, as we send money home, because we send money home, a lot of money, so that they get some money and an interest on top of that. All those funds, the each of the local government areas are supposed to get something called a monthly allocation from the Federal Account Allocation Committee. It is important that we are explaining this, because when you know that your money is, there's money coming to your local government every month, it is your job now as citizens to now know where those monies are going. The government don't want you to know. The government don't want you to ask any questions. But if you don't ask any questions, you will continue to suffer. That's the point that's been made. So now we've talked about how the funds are coming in. To be able to question them, we need to know this section of that constitution very, very well in our local languages. That is why I am sharing it. We need this to go viral. We need our people to know that they possess powers that they have never used in 24 years. And we're going to teach them how they're going to use it. This has to be from each community. It's going to start within our community. To start changing our mindset, to believe that, to make sure that it is standing together collectively that we will get the roads we want, the water, the light, the schools, the bridges, the healthcare, the safety, the security, and so on and so forth. It is of immense importance that we understand that. And that's what we're trying to do when we do programs like this, to raise the level of awareness in our communities so that people can begin to understand that the only option that we have now is for us to actively participate in our governance. We've tried the Bible and the Quran over 30 years. It has got us nowhere. And it will continue to close your mind and close your eyes. Let me tell you a little story about myself. This is exactly how the drug, the mental drug you call religion, this is how it's actually taking over your mind. I had a car accident. I'm speaking from personal experience. I had a car accident back in September 2005. That accident resulted in what I am today, sadly, whereby I have a chronic pain. Now, in the middle of that, after a few months, when they couldn't work out what it was and everything else, I was on drugs. I was taking diazepam, cocodamol, amitriptyline, morphine, pregabalin, gabapentin, naproxen. I was taking really powerful drugs. So much so that I didn't know whether I was coming or going. I didn't know. I was just taking it. And that is what Christianity and Islam is doing to you. You're just going. Some of you are just going to the churches and the mosques because you've been trained. It is a routine. It has become a routine to just go to the church and pray. That is the solution that you see as a solution. But it's not. It is just a routine. The same thing with my medication. I was taking so much of the medication. And what happened? I got hooked. I got hooked on the medication. I kept wanting more. Morphine. The more you take the morphine, the more you want it. The more you pray as a Christian, the more you pray as an Islamic person, the more you are going to continue to pray. You get absorbed into it. So much so, in my case, I took those drugs. It got to a point when I was going on holiday, one of them ran out, the morphine. I had a panic. I called my doctor from abroad and I said, please, I need more of this medication now. It has run out. I can't cope. I was shaking. I was panicking. So they got me the medication. Now, when I got back, the doctor called me into a meeting, said, I need to speak to you. Yeah. And he said, I'm afraid, Mr. Agunumu, you are hooked on drugs. What do you mean? I needed it. No. I'm sorry. You're hooked. You're going to have to come off it. What do you mean? No. You have to come off. The drugs are not working for you. I can see. You're taking more. It's not working. You're going to have to come off the drugs. I had to come off every single drug. Pay attention, please. Pay attention. I had to come off every single drug. That is what you need to begin to look at. This, and the particular one in particular, morphine. It took me 2.5 years to come off morphine. It took me 2.5 years to come off the morphine because I had to come off in small milligrams. Now, in the process of coming off it, I was having cold sweats and shakes because my body wanted it. I was like, I need it. The point I'm making is that the religions, if you don't, because you've been so much into it for so long, it's part of you. If you don't take it, you will feel wrong. Your body will trick you to think you need it. This is all psychology. What we are talking about here is all psychology. And we need to understand the psychology of how they have placed us where they have placed us using religion. It is all psychological. And we need to understand that. And what we are trying to do is to put in place the actual steps you can take to free yourselves. Do you know that the Bible and the Quran, they possess no powers like you possess as sovereigns? Do you know that? Did you know that? You didn't. Okay. Let me show you something. I'm going to bring that up as well. I will keep this on the screen. Let me show you something. I need you to understand. Please do share this broadcast. Now, I'm going to bring that up. Okay. So I'm leaving that up there. I'm moving that up. So I want you to see this here. Now, please pay close attention to what I'm showing you on the screen. The words that you see that's scrolling here, you see? If any other law goes against the Constitution, it states, Section 1, Subsection 3, this Constitution shall prevail and that other law shall be void. That is in Section 1, Subsection 3 of the Nigerian Constitution, 1999 Constitution. What I just read to you is in the Constitution. What does it mean? Well, let me tell you. What it means is this. It means that the laws in the Quran or the Bible, they are superseded by the laws in the Constitution. As flawed as it is, I know that Nigerian Constitution is flawed, but it is superseded by it. And this is what we are trying to get us to really understand collectively. We need to understand that the powers that we possess is more powerful than the Bible and the Quran that you hold on to. Many of you will carry the Bible. Yes, I am this. I am that. I have it here. This one happens to be a Mormon Bible. Sorry about that. This happens to be a Mormon Bible. I have it here. See? See? Those of you watching on TikTok. The Bible. Oh, yes. They hold it close. I'm a child of God. I'm this and that. It's mental enslavement. I'm sorry to say it. It is mental enslavement. All hail James Friday. Thank you very much, my brother. It is mental enslavement. And we need to wake you up. This has been nothing more than a way to confuse you, to enslave your mind, to make you never hold those in government to power. The pastors and the imams, they sit and they eat with the government. The government instruct them to keep you distracted, like the drug that I was taking. See, the drug, it wasn't working. The drug stopped working. It never did work. But I was taking it, and I kept taking more. It didn't stop or solve my problem. I put on weight. At one point, when I was taking the drugs, I was 130 kilos. 130 kilos. That was how much I weighed. That was when, and I would snore. When I snored, the whole house would be shaking. And I kept thinking, this is not right. This is not, I can't do this. What do I stop? And the doctor said, you have to come off it. Like I said, it took me 2.5 years to come off it. The same thing is what will happen with the religion. It's going to take years. You're not going to stop all of a sudden. I'm not expecting anybody to suddenly stop. But you need to understand, if it is the day you understand that they have used the religion to close your eyes, to prevent you from holding them to account, that is the day that you are free. That is the day that you are free. So, please keep in mind, it says, if any other law is inconsistent with this constitution shall prevail, and that other law shall, to the extent of the inconsistency, shall be deemed null and void. That is what it says in that section. So what that means is that those of you, the pastors and the imams carrying the Bible, believe in the Bible, believe in the Quran. The Quran and the Bible, they don't have any power compared to the Constitution. As flawed as the Constitution is, quote me on that. You can quote me on that. And you need to know this in our communities. Our people in the communities, they believe in the Bible. Like I said, they believe in that Bible. They hold on to the Bible and the Quran everywhere. It's in our local languages. Here's one more thing I want you to understand. Why is it that the government have ensured that we, the people, never had the constitution in our local languages? Why? Have you thought about that? Have you thought about why they haven't? Why haven't they done that? Yes? Why? Have you thought about that? They don't want us to know what is in the constitution, because if we did know, we will be able to hold them to account like we are about to start doing. The constitution is written only in English. Now, they said they had it in Yoruba. I've gone in another language. I've tried to source it. I haven't been able to see it anywhere. But you can see it on the screen. Let me show you quickly as we're here now. So I'm going to make that smaller. I'll make this bigger. 1 second, please. Please do share this broadcast. We're here to really open our eyes and help us really, you know, begin to hold our governors to account. It's no longer about just talk anymore now. We need collective action to address the concerns that we face, and many of us. Like I told you, you can wait on the government all you want. www.citizenewa.org. You see that there? So let me make that bigger here. So 1 second. So that's where I've gone now. So I'm going to go into there. And I want you to see the constitution in Yoruba language so that you understand that you can, for the first time, be able to read the constitution in your local language. For Yoruba people, and those who are my Igbo brothers, you can use that as a way to also, you know, put that in place, because I don't speak Igbo, so I'm not sure. I don't think I can actually do that work. It requires effort from collectively as many of us as possible. Now, and many Igbo speakers. Now, so I'm gonna go into this section. You're gonna see me go in here. So proposed constitution. No, sorry, not that one. We're going to just go in here. Let's just go in here. So now you will see there's a song that I've got there that I wrote. I don't want to play this now because Facebook, they are very, very funny. When I play my own song now, they're telling me I can't play it on it, which is a joke. But anyway, that's another story for another time. I've written and given them evidence that I wrote the song. How long am I going to suffer? But if I play it on it, they start muting the broadcast. So now we go into the 1999 Constitution in Yoruba. So here you go. For those of you who are watching, you will see there's a key sign here. And then you click on that one. You won't be able to see this on TikTok, but that's why we say join us on Facebook. So we go up and you will see the Constitution in your language. So, for example, where I've been talking about that, where they don't possess powers, yeah? The Bible and the Quran possesses no powers. And many people don't know that. And that's what we're trying to wake you up to. They don't know that. It says here, Ti ofin eikeyi ko ba ni ibamu pelu awon ipese ti ofin orilede yi. Ofin yi yo bori ati pe ofin miran yo si iye ti aisedede je ofo. Which means that if any law is inconsistent with the Constitution of Nigeria, that other law shall be, to the extent of the inconsistency, be void. And that is what I'm trying to say to us. So we need our community. So many people who have believed, millions of us have believed that the Constitution and the Bible and the Quran is more powerful than the Constitution. It isn't. I've given you the evidence. I am providing you with the evidence. We need to be sharing this across all our platforms. Because that is what they've been using to come. You see now how they've used this to now to close our minds, to capture our minds. Many people, you see that it is easy for people to access information about the Bible and the Quran. They make it easy for you to have. But for the Constitution, to have it in your language, they don't want you to have it. Because they want to keep you in the dark. You see, when I say now, do you get why I'm saying that the Bible and the Quran, they are drugs, they are opiums of the mind to close your mind, to make you believe and trust the lies told by those in government? I'm showing you so you understand the steps we must take. Our people in our local languages must understand that the Constitution of Nigeria, within Nigeria, has more power than the Quran and the Bible combined. It has more power. Michael Chris, thank you. Ireti Adediji, thank you very much. Tolokwe Ezeife, thank you very much. Miki Muya, thank you very much. Muya, thank you. Omowumi Beki, thank you very much. James Friday, all hail Oduduwa. All hail Biafra as well. I mean, I don't have a problem supporting and stating that. We have a right to self-determination. We have a right to self-determination. And we can express that. So I stand firmly with that. I don't have a problem. And I'll keep saying for the government, they need to release Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. He must be released. We continue to call for that. And we support that. And we advocate for that as often as we can. Now, so we need our people to understand, even if we are going to, and for me, this is what I believe we need to do before we achieve So thank you very much for joining us. I appreciate you. We're still talking about the Nigerian government, and the people are suffering, and we are giving reasons why you need to continue to support the Nigerian government, support the people to wake up and begin to hold our governors to account. I've just shown you now that the Bible and the Quran that you thought was powerful, compared to our Constitution, they have no power. They have created an illusion for you to believe in the Quran and this Bible. They created an illusion. They don't possess any powers. They've created an illusion for you to believe in this. And when you hold on to it, you believe you have power. But it's got no power. It's got zero powers. Because the Constitution says, if any other law is inconsistent with the Constitution, that other law, to the extent of the inconsistency, shall be deemed to be null and void. Which means that any law that you see within the Quran or in the Bible will not be applicable on Nigerian soil. It is only the Constitution. But many people don't know this. And that is why we are calling on us. This belief that you are going to go for Yoruba Nation and Biafra Nation without our people knowing this fundamental part, key part. Because when they know this, now they know why they are going for self-determination. Now you will understand why it is important for you to go for self-determination, because you can see the serious flaws in the Constitution. And what is more, the people who are in government, they swear on oath by this Constitution. But because they've kept you in the dark, they do not uphold what is inside that Constitution. Are you following me? I hope this makes sense. Are you following me? I hope this makes sense, please. So it is important that we begin to really work together as a community. We have no other choice now. We really have no other choice but to begin to work together in our communities and begin to spread the word about the Constitution. Please, that doesn't mean I believe in one Nigeria. I personally don't. I don't. But to be able to get to Yoruba Nation, we need to be part and parcel of the governance. Begin to question those we elect into office. Some local government areas in Nigeria, they are getting 1 billion naira a month. Alimosho local government in case in point. Yet, the people are suffering. Where is that money going? Because you are busy in the church praying that government come and help. You are praying in the mosque. The money, the government is taking some of that, taking all the money and give some to the pastors and the imams to keep you blinded. That is what is happening. I kid you not. That is why you need to begin to read that constitution in your local language. Begin to hold them to account. And don't tell me, oh, it is impossible. We can't do it. If you can take the time to say, government, come and beg us. If you are government, please help us. You are better off using that energy to hold them to account. It's about mindset change. It's about mindset change. And we need our market women, particularly, who are the ones screaming now. Some of them are widows. The widows, they are amazing women. Because despite being widows, they were selling their peppers and their carrots and their bitter leaves and their, the dried fish. That is what they used to sell to get many students into university. They are amazing people, but they didn't. If they knew this, they wouldn't have to struggle. That's the point I'm making. But many didn't know it. For 24 years, we didn't know we possessed the power that you're seeing on the screen. Section 14.2a, which you're seeing on the screen right now. In Yoruba. A second place. I want to make sure you got that right. Yeah. This one here. 14.2a. In Yoruba, just want you to really comprehend what we're saying, to understand that we have the powers. So 14.2, okay, and finally C. And what they've done is to cleverly put it in a way, they've hidden this from you. You will just think, oh, it doesn't mean anything. But those things that you see highlighted on the screen, they are powerful pieces of information. They are more powerful than the Bible and the Quran. But those pastors and imams, they don't want you to know this, because if you know it, it's bad business for them. Because of the psychology. That is why when you hear, for me, I look at the pastors and imams on Nigeria. They are fraudsters. They are collectively fraudsters. They are telling you God said I'm going to. One of them said, oh, God said I'm going to buy me 3 jet planes. He's going to buy me 3 jet planes. But the same, and they're giving you, they tell people to come and give testimonies about how God has made their life better. But they never talk about the testimony of how God has made sure that the entire state, the entire nation has got infrastructure. But they'll come and tell you testimony. They make it individual. So you make you believe in the lie. There is no testimony of anything. It's a lie. It is pure, straight lie. They are there doing the bidding of the government. The government is even instructing them to make sure that they will say miracle, miracle, miracle. For you to believe in the lie, they engineer miracles for you to believe in the lie. That's what we are here to wake you up. You need to wake up. Section 14.2a states, sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria from whom the government, through this constitution, derives all its powers and authority. You are a sovereign. You are a sovereign, and you need to begin to use those powers. We are here to teach you how to use the powers. Now, let me give an example of how you can use the powers I've been talking about for some time now. Now that you know that you're a sovereign, the first thing we need to do is to call meeting in each of the local government areas, in your villages. By this time, we'll make sure that you have the constitution in your local language, such as you see on the screen. What we want to do is to make sure that this booklet is available in our communities so people can begin to read in their language, particularly the market women, the farmers, the vulcanizers, to know the powers they possess in the language. So that when a politician comes in, they will say, no, that's not right. We are the sovereigns. You are here to serve us. In their language. Again, it's about mindset. It's about mindset. We need to change the mindset. And that is what I'm hoping, that by doing programs like this, it can begin to awaken our people. It's not going to be a straightforward thing. Like I said, it took me 2.5 years to come totally off the drugs. It took me 2.5 years to come off the drugs that I've been taking. Now, I do not use any drugs whatsoever. I use my mind, and I use hydrotherapy, and I try and use relaxation, because I realize the drugs don't work. What I'm saying to you is that the Bible and the Quran, they have never worked, and they will never work. They have never worked, and they will never work, because they're designed to enslave your mind. We need our people to wake up from that. What we must focus on is what you see on the screen. Section 14.2a, sovereignty. You have it in English and in Yoruba. The English version is what you see here. The Yoruba version is what you see on the screen there. So they are both on the screen at the same time. The idea is to get you to familiarize yourself with the powers you possess. And of course, now you know, and you're hearing it here, loud and clear, that the Constitution, as flawed as it is, has more power in the jurisdiction of Nigeria than the Bible and the Quran. Fact. It states so there. So, let me proceed. 14.2a. Sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria from whom the government, through this constitution, derives all its powers and authority. You can see it on the screen as you watch, those of you on Facebook. Thank you for joining us. Please don't forget, subscribe to Citizen NY on YouTube. Help us grow the platform. The work we are doing here is to awaken the minds of our people. And please do not for 1 minute believe that it is impossible. Now, it is very possible. But we need to be involved in it. So as you are watching, make sure that you play your part and share the broadcast to as many people as possible. That is the best way you can help us. And of course, subscribe to Citizen NY on YouTube. So, once again, 14.2a. Sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria from whom government through this constitution derives all its powers and authority. 14.2c goes on to state, the participation by the people in the government shall be ensured in accordance with the provisions of this constitution. Now, because you are a sovereign, it is mandated that you have powers of authority. You have they derive the powers and authority from you. And you can question your government. as stated under Section 42C, which is the participation by the people in the government, shall be ensured in accordance with the provisions of this constitution. Now, to read that in Yoruba, 42A, ijoba je ti awon eyan Nigeria lati odo nijoba nipase ofin orilede ngbagbogbara ati asere. 42C, ikopa awon eniyan nijoba won godo daju ni ibamu pelu awon ofin orilede. Now, the reason I'm reading this to you and I'm repeatedly saying it is that once you get familiar and know those power, those words, we need to share those words with our market women. So here's to make it easier for you in Yoruba. I've already done something. There's something I did moments ago. So for our market women, please take a screenshot. 1 minute. Please take a screenshot of what you see in the middle of the page there. Take a screenshot now for Yoruba-speaking people. Take a screenshot. And those of you who may, know people who are speaking Yoruba, take a screenshot, because those are the most powerful pieces of information that we, the people, need to have access to right now in our local languages. And it states, you can see it on there. Nipa bayi o ti kede pe ijoba je ti awon eniyan Nigeria lati odo ni tijoba nipase ofin orilede yin gba gbogbo agbara ati ase re. This is not going to happen overnight. Please, that is why I am very comfortable to continue to build and talk about this on a daily basis, on as many platforms, in many instances, and weaving it into the concerns that we face collectively in our communities on a daily basis. It's going to take time. It's going to take time, but we need you to please don't just watch alone. Each and every one of you that have been on here, Afo Sonya, thank you very much. And then Peter Aluya, thank you for those of you joining us. I'm trying to mention as many names as I see on the screen, because it's really important that we begin to understand that we can make this change. I'm telling you that no. Okay, sorry, but I'm just checking. Now, there is no other way for us to achieve the change that we wish to see than participating in our governance. The Bible and the Quran, as I've stated to you on many ways instances now, is a waste of your time. They may design to keep your mind occupied and never hold the government to account. Well, once you start exercising the powers that you see on the screen in Yoruba language here, I'll see if I can bring the English one up as well. Just for fairness purposes, let's see. I think I have it here somewhere. This is the English version of that as well. To a closer one, you can have it on there. Take a screenshot of that. Share it with family and friends. Again, it states, 14:2a, it is hereby accordingly declared that sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria, from whom the government, through this constitution, derives all its powers and authority. And then, of course, Section 14.2c, the participation by the people in the government shall be ensured in accordance with the provisions of this constitution. Now, these are things, please keep in mind, as I'm saying this, I don't have any confidence in the Nigerian government and constitution. No. But the only way that we can make the change that we need is to participate in the process, expose the flaws in the constitution, begin to hold those we elect into office to account. So how do you do that now? Let's go into specifics now about how you can do this in your community. Now that you have this information in both Yoruba and in English language, and hopefully other languages as well, one of the things that we need to do is to have meetings in your community. As sovereigns, you have the power to call your local government chairman, state as a representative member, House of Reps, senators, you have the even president and governors. You have the power to call them to local meetings. Because why? You are sovereigns. And they cannot refuse. And you know why they cannot refuse? Because they swear on oath. Let me read you the section about that oath. We need to really break this down so you understand that the powers you possess. And this is what you can use as a whole to make sure that they understand that they're not going to go anywhere. Let's go and look at this section. They will swear on oath somewhere. And that's what I want you to know I wanted to bring to your attention. Let me see if I can find it. One second, please. I'm just going to show you. Now, here we go. Yeah. Oath of office. You see? Oath of allegiance. See? Let me go and look at the oaths. The seventh schedule. Yeah? Oh, they won't let me show it on here. It's not going to let me go into it. But they've got oath of office as part of the oath of president, oath of governor, president, deputy governor, members, house of assembly, all of that. You see? So they swear on oath to protect and defend that constitution. Part of that is for them to apply that constitution to the letter, what it states in the constitution. And what it states is that you are a sovereign. And you have to remind them that that is the the document they swore on oath by. And in that constitution, it tells them that they have to serve we the sovereigns. They are servants to we the sovereigns. These are things that I'm trying to really get us to understand. Because it says, having solemnly resolved to live in unity and harmony as one individual, indivisible, indissoluble sovereign nation under God, dedicated to promotion of African sovereignty, peace, and international cooperation, you know, and also to provide for a constitution for the purposes of promoting good government welfare. You see, those words there, you can hold them to it because that is what underpins the fact that you are a sovereign. I'm telling you the fact of the matter. Again, it is in Yoruba. I will show you the Yoruba version of that as well. Let's go to the Yoruba version of it. PowerPoint. So, let's show you the Yoruba version of that. Ni obata ti ponu pe this here. Now, is it here? Yeah. Ofin orilede yi je to julo ati pe awon ipese re yo ni ipa ti yo lori awon alase ti awon eniyan. Then we'll know. Yes, only. So our ara apapo Nigeria ni won bi ati pinu lati gbe ni isokan ati isokan gege bi orilede alase kan ti a ko le pinya ti a ko si le pinya labe Olorun ti a se igbeyin a igbega ti isokan ti kalaye matun. I will check all of that anyway. Africa ti agbalaye Africa alaafin agbaye ifowosopo agbaye ati oye ati lati pese fun ofin kan fun idi ti igbega ijoba rere ati ironlowo fun gbogbo eniyan ni orilede wa. So you see, all of these are evidence. These are documented evidence that you need to put before those people that we've elected in the office. So I'm just showing you this now. So now what we will do is we will first of all have a meeting. By this time, this is why it's important that this information that I'm going to show you again in English, that it is, we need to saturate our communities with this information in English and in their local languages. We need to saturate it. So they would have that information in that. And take screenshots as you're watching it, please. Take a screenshot and start sharing it. We need to saturate our communities with this information. Because that way, the people will know their rights, that they are sovereigns. And they need to work together. Never work in isolation when it comes to this project, please. Never work in isolation. You need to work in all the communities together. Never work in isolation. Okay, now, so what this will now do is this. What this means is that once you call a town hall meeting, as I said, every community must do this. Call a town hall meeting. Local government chairman, state house of assembly members, house of reps, senators, governors. Insist, demand that they come to your local government area. And they are all representatives to you, the people. As a sovereign, collectively, you have the power to demand they come to a meeting where you can discuss issues that's affecting your community. You have that power as sovereigns. you have that power as sovereigns. Now, at that meeting, you will then read to them what I'm going to show you here. You will read this to them. Sorry about that. Is that it? Yes. You will read this to them. As they are sitting down, you greet them. Good afternoon to you all. Welcome on board. Before we start our meeting today, thank you for attending. Before we start the meeting today, we need to put a gentle reminder to you all, the elected and appointed officials, and listen intently. You need to listen to what we are about to say and to consider it and to make sure that you abide by that, because it is in the constitution that you were sworn on oath under. Then you read this to them. Sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria, from whom the government, through this constitution, derives all its powers and authority. Which means that the local government chairman, your House of Assembly member, your House of Reps, your senators, they are answerable to we, the sovereigns, collectively. And you stop there for a minute. We want you to think about that. And that should inform your every action from here on. And I would suggest that from here on, at every meeting, that section 14.2a must be read to all government officials at every meeting, at every local government meeting. That is the way we can make the change. Not by praying. Ayomiku Daniju, my brother, welcome on board. Afu Sonya, thank you so much. Zainab Uki, thank you very much. Thank you very much, Ayomiku, my brother. And those of you, you do have the opportunity to call in if you do want to call in. Let me see if I can call my brother and we may talk about things. I think we spoke yesterday. Yesterday's program was in Yoruba, but this is going to a little bit more detail as well, in more specific terms for us to understand what is going on. So what I am saying to you is this. You can see now there's a process. The process is call a meeting. As sovereigns, you have the power to call local government, you call your local government officials, your local government chairman, state house members, house of reps, senators, governors. You have the power to call them to a meeting, town hall meeting, where they will have to listen to your concerns. But you start off with reminding them of the powers of sovereignty that you, the citizens, possess. And that is why it is important you have a screenshot of this in every community for all of you to have on your phones and to know it off-head, to be ready to challenge those we elect into office. We need that information to spread. So if you are watching and you haven't shared this information, please share. I urge you to please share. Let me see if my brother is up for a chat. Others may want to call. You may wish to call, and that you're welcome to do so. And let me see if I can put this up quickly. Is that going to work? 1 second. No, actually, I can't do that now. Actually, I'll see. I may not be able to. I'll try it anyway. It may not allow me. So let me just do this one. Let me see. Let me see if it will pick it up. Yeah, I think it will. Yeah. Let me see I'm calling you now from the other number. So maybe he may want to say a few words. I just want to just hear from him for a few words. If you're able to talk, let me know. If not, that's fine. You know, you can leave a comment if you're not able to. I think he may be busy. I just saw him online and I thought I'd just pop in and say a quick word. Okay, Ayomiku, that's me calling in case you're wondering. So, okay, anyway, I think it's busy. For the number is open. You can call in on +44 7399 580 606 if you want to add one or two words to what you're hearing thus far. Does it make sense to you? Do you agree? Do you have concerns? Do you have suggestions? Do you have ways? We also welcome you to come up with suggestions yourselves as to how we can actually empower our people. Because now, this is about changing the mentality of our people. The solution for the bad governance and the bad roads and the religious intolerance and the abductions and the killings and all of the banditry and all of that going on is our active participation in our governance, holding those we elect to office to account. That is what we must collectively do. I put it to you all. I hope this makes sense. I hope you are finding this of immense and important relevance. Please do share this broadcast. You are, of course, watching Citizen AY, the platform where we speak truth to power. We really want to make a very, very big difference in the lives of our community. It is no longer about funding. I can tell you that the funds, if you are trying to build some funds to challenge these people, you are wasting your time. It's now about using the knowledge that we have, encouraging our people to know the powers they possess in the constitution and the language, and encouraging them to stand collectively together. Because when people know this now, they will not be readily, easily able to say, the government is, they're going to give me 5,000 naira, I'll take that. Because we know that they are using that to oppress us. So that mindset is what we really need to change. That's why what we are doing here is to bring that to each and everyone's attention, so that we begin to understand that what has been done here is unjust, is wrong, and we have powers that we must begin to teach to our children. I put it to you that also what you've seen on the screen, both the English and the Yoruba version of this, should be taught to our children in their at the age of four, from the age of four upwards. Because what has been done, many of us now, we've been brainwashed. We've been brainwashed. I'm saying it myself included. We've been brainwashed to such an extent that we do not believe that we possess powers to hold our governors to account. And that's brainwashing. So we need to empower our people. The coming generation must be empowered with what you see in the book here, on the screen. And once you empower them, it is easier for us to achieve the ultimate goal, self-determination. We empower them with the knowledge, making them know that they have the power to hold those elected into office to account and actually exercise those powers on a consistent basis. That is what we're trying to really bring to your attention today. I hope that makes sense. I hope you can relate to what we're saying. Please do leave a comment. Let us hear from you. And we greet and recognize each and every one of you as you're coming in. We welcome stars as well to help us. The best way, of course, they can help us is to subscribe to Citizen AY on YouTube. Go ahead and subscribe to Citizen AY on YouTube. Hit the notification button. Give us thumbs up. Help us reach more people, because we really need to put an end to the suffering that we've been suffering. Many people seem to believe that the Bible and the Quran is the solution. I am here to tell you categorically that it is not the solution. Indeed, it is the way that they're using to keep us enslaved. We've been enslaved for over 60 years. But in terms of the Constitution, we've been enslaved for over 24 years. We didn't know the powers that you're seeing on the screen, that we had it and we have not used it. Now we're trying to encourage us to do that. That is the only solution we have left. Praying to Jesus Christ or Muhammad in the sky, they're not going to come and help us. They won't come from above to help. They don't speak our language. They don't know who we are. The people that they know are Arabs. Muhammad knows Arabs. Jesus Christ knows Europeans. And if they have any concerns, those are the concerns that their gods will go and attend to first. Because that's who they know. They don't know you and I. Nothing to do with us. Yet we have our own orishas, and we abandon it. That's why part of the reason why we're suffering. We need to reconnect to who we are collectively as Africans. We must do so. That's another, but that's the story for later on. So let's see now. So what I am saying to you all is, please go right now to www.citizenawa.org. Download or keep a copy of that constitution in your Yoruba language. Begin to use it in your communities. We will need every community to participate in this. And what we want to do is we will roll out a program whereby there will be training programs that's going to be tied onto doing Zoom live broadcasts. So we're in the process of organizing something along that line. We'll give you updates on that as that develops. So I hope this is making some sense to you all, that the reason why we must begin to actively participate in our governance. What has been happening is that we have been bystanders. whilst those in government have been operating and carrying out the looting of the nation's resources with impunity. But with our active participation in our governance from here on, once we begin to do that, it will be more difficult for them to do that because they are going to be accountable to you and I. Because why? We are sovereigns. We want that way that we're sovereigns, and now we need that to be something that our people take on board and be able to use to hold those they elect into office to account. So I hope this is making sense. So we need this to be happening at every meeting. We need every local government area to set up meetings with all of the elected officials, president, vice president, House of Reps, senators, Senate president, you know, State of Assembly members, local government chairman, all of them. They have to be accountable to you and I, using the powers of sovereignty as you see on the screen. Take a screenshot. The Yoruba one has been there for a time. Again, let me make this. That's another example. In fact, can I show you that? Maybe I will, yeah.
Authority will only let my adult Okada do me by. Just because you are in uniform.
You see, what he did there is what we need to begin to do. But this time, we need to do it as a community. Never do it on your own. Some people may have influence to do it, but it is best you begin to exercise these powers collectively in each community. But that's what I'm trying to do. That's what I really wanted to talk about. And I wanted to just... here is what you need to remember. You need our people to know that they're sovereigns and have the power to hold their government to account using the powers within that constitution, section 14.2c. The participation by the people in the government shall be ensured in accordance with the provisions of this constitution. That means that you can question the government, and that's what we want to encourage you to do. Praying and saying, God, come and help. Muhammad is not going to come from the sky to help you. Forget it. It doesn't even know who you are. Jesus Christ doesn't know who you are. You need to wake up. And those powers, those books, they do not have any constitutional power. They don't have any constitutional power. So when you go, when you hold the book and you're holding it, you are just enslaving your mind to the hands of those people who have put those people there to enslave your mind. It is time we collectively woke up. I hope this is making sense. I hope you guys see what we're saying here, and we need to act upon it. For each and every one of us that has been following us, please make sure you share this podcast to reach as many people as possible. Because we are looking at solutions. We are looking at practical solutions that we can take on now. We're not talking about anything else other than to awaken our people. And it's our right to do so, to empower people. Because ultimately, many of us in diaspora, we are having to send money home to people because the government has failed them. And because they didn't know that they have the powers to participate and hold the government to account, that has made things even worse. Now we need to address that collectively. Okay, so let me park that for now. And then we'll go and do one thing that I wanted to show you, if I can show you that one. Sorry, let me just quickly go. I need you to understand something. There's something that's about to happen, and it's a big concern. Huge concern. And we need to be aware of it. Do not. 602. I'll call that one. 1 minute. Where is it? Sorry, 1 minute. Where is it? Well, we'll see it come up in a minute. But if I don't see it, I can still talk about it anyway. We are hearing, to closing things off now, we're going to talk about the loan that the Nigerian government is seeking to get to help the economy going. They're looking at getting something like $7 billion loan for improvement of infrastructure and everything else. We don't have any confidence that money is going to go on there. Again, you need to participate in that process. And we need our people to begin to question, using the powers of sovereignty in each of the community, to question our governance. Tell them, remind them that we are sovereigns. It is something that has to be done collectively. We must do that collectively. Now, let me just take this one for a second, please. thought I had it here, but I don't see it. 1 second, please. 1 minute. Where is it? Just checking something for a minute. Oh, okay. No, I'm going to come back to that one later. I don't want to do that one just yet. We don't want to do that one just yet. Give me a minute, please. Where is it? No, that's not it. One minute, we'll try one more time. Just give me a minute, please, then we'll probably wrap it up after this. But I wanted to give you some concrete evidence to back what I was saying. It's not just about just hearsay. It's actually really important information that came to light in the last few days. That's not it. Here we go. Good. Got it. So before I close, this is something I want you to be aware of. Nigeria seeks to borrow $8 billion. So they want to borrow 700 and something billion from US and $1 billion. So 7 billion from US, 1 billion from UK. Asked for the Senate to approve nearly $8 billion in the new debt as part of 2022-24 external borrowing to plan to finance infrastructure, health, education, and security. How many of you think that money will end up being spent on the things that stays here, or it's going to be lining their pockets? I have to believe it's the latter. They'll be lining their pockets. So what they plan to do is here's what was really happening, and you need to understand this. Many African countries are being told to come to meetings, and Caribbeans. And in those meetings, they are told to sign documents that's promoting LGBTQ, in those African countries. So far, many of them have refused. That is not freedom of speech. Those countries have the right to say no. But now, what they're trying to do is to loan the money. They are saying what's going to happen is that he will have to loan the money on condition that they promote, the LGBT thing that you see on the screen. Then there's nothing wrong in people being that. But when when the African continent is suffering, African continent is suffering from the injustices of colonialism and impoverishment, and even the economic structures have been designed in such a way as to render our currencies worthless. To put this as our priority shows it displays mental enslavement. To put this as our priority, whereby, you're going to get a loan on condition that you promote LGBT. But they don't care about the health of the people. They don't care about the health of Africans. They've been chasing this and going to many African countries. Let me read, I'm going to read you something. In fact, let me do that. I'm going to read this. I will read you this because you need to understand what has been done, because many people are not aware of what has been done and the impact of what they've done on us. So it is important that we actually reflect and raise this. Somebody brought this up, and I'm going to read the entire document to you if time will allow. Let me show you what I mean. We're going to read the entire document to make sure you understand and grasp exactly what I'm saying here. It's not about trying to be anti anything. It's just understanding what has been done and the likely impact and why we cannot be silent in the face of what I've just read, because if we do, it just doesn't even. Now, I'm going to read it to you. So let's read it together. Let's see. There we go. Okay. So, why Nigeria and others must not sign the LGBT agreement by Sony Ekwuusi. On November 15, 2023, might be a tragic day for Africa and the entire Caribbean and Pacific region. It is the day set aside by the European Union, EU, to pressure or coax African, Caribbean, and Pacific countries into signing the deceptively and euphemistically crafted LGBT agreement between EU and ACP countries. You may well be aware that over the past few months, several meetings have been convened between EU and ACP parliamentarians aimed at getting ACP leaders to sign the controversial LGBT agreement. For example, a crucial meeting between EU and ACP ministers took place in Brussels on November 20, 2022, to potentially exert great pressure on ACP ministers to persuade ACP heads of government to sign the contentious LGBT agreement. Another meeting with the same objective took place from June 19 to 28, 2023 in Brussels. The aforementioned meetings ended in a deadlock as ACP parliamentarians and leaders vehemently opposed the signing of the LGBT agreement. This is why we are so shocked to hear today that the November 15th has been scheduled for signing of the offensive LGBT agreement. The pertinent questions are, have ACP heads of government compromised their earlier stance on this matter and now agreed to sign the controversial LGBT agreement? If so, why did African leaders consult? Did African leaders consult their respective parliament and the people before agreeing to sign the agreement? You see why I keep talking about we, the sovereigns. They have to consult us, and because we are not participating in that process, they bypass us. We need to participate in that process using the powers that you see on the screen. This is providing clear indication. We have no other choice but to begin to participate in that process. Our goal remains to go for self-determination. But to achieve it, we need to participate, because now they are passing laws that is going to impact the lives of the coming generations. And we are busy saying Jesus Christ this, Allah that. Those who are passing those things, they are using it as a distraction. Let us read on. Okay. So why is African media... So it's the LGBT agreement. If so, why did African leaders consult their respective parliamentarians and people before agreeing to sign the agreement? Why is African media not reporting the LGBT negotiations between EU and ACP countries since 2021? They've been trying to do this since 2021. One is certain. If the ACP government succumbed to the EU's intimidation and signed LGBT, can you see? Now, when we talk about the fact that colonization is still in place, they will say we are talking nonsense. What they're doing, bypassing the impoverishment of African nations who are living in poverty as a result of the colonial construct, they don't care about what Africans want on African soil. They are imposing their will. They're trying to impose yet more injustice to undermine African nations. You see why we need to participate in the process? Don't leave it to God. We cannot leave it to God. That's my thinking. That's what I'm trying to really... You know, this is sheer hypocrisy. The same people who carved up Africa without asking Africans or without Africans on the table are now imposing their own belief systems or whatever it is they want to do. And nobody... I don't have a problem with whoever wants to practice whatever they want in their country. But why impose it? The same countries who are preventing, exploiting our resources, forcing our people to flee to other countries, and yet again coming to impose something that the people do not want. Can you see the injustice? Can you see the injustice? So these are the kind of things that we are talking about. I'm going to say hi to people who are on TikTok with me. Thank you very much for joining. So the EU is engaged in trying to get African countries to sign LGBT. And that is what is totally unacceptable. We don't have to. Please hear me. There is nothing, if those who want to practice it, that is their custom in Greece, many, you know, in the history, we know that. That is what happened in Greece and all those places and other empires, you know, around Europe. That's fine. And nobody's going to question. Nobody's going to say, no, don't, you know, you can't do that. That's up to you, you know. But what is not acceptable is to try to impose this on Africa, on top of the fact that they, as we speak, 11 to 13 African countries are being forced to use CFA, a French printed currency that the French themselves don't use. And yet, if you talk about it, they say, oh, no, 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 you are just talking nonsense. Oh, forget it. It's all in the past. It is not in the past. The point is, it is not in the past. And the clear attempt to force African countries to sign into law in their countries, LGBT laws, legalizing it, is actually tantamount to oppression of Africans on African soil. That is what is happening. But they don't... Many people are not even allowed to speak about it. They want to do it undercover. And yet they're telling us Africa is free. Where is the freedom when you're not allowed to continue your life without interference from abroad? Where's the freedom? Where is the freedom? I'm asking, where's the freedom? So let's read on. Okay, so now. So it says here, one thing is certain. If the ACP government succumbs to the EU's intimidation and sign LGBT agreement, it will spell doom for ACP countries. Why? Because the agreement is primarily aimed at homosexualization and LGBTization of ACP countries. The agreement, which takes the form of a treaty, is deceptively deviously worded to impose EU's LGBT agenda on ACP countries. Here we go again. We are talking about that the Berlin Conference has actually destroyed Africa. Africa is trying to still not recovered from it. We are still not free. And yet they are trying to put yet more imposition on us. We need to speak up. We need to speak up. And the reason I'm tying this to the 700 billion naira is the condition upon which that 700 billion naira, $800 billion will be given is that the government of Nigeria will have to agree to this LGBT. Yes. They will have to agree to it. Because now it's now the foundation for the new way, third way to take over. We need to say no to this. You see that we cannot afford to leave this in the hands of the government. The government are already hiding the fact that we are sovereigns. Yeah. And they will sign into law things that we, the sovereigns, are unaware of if we don't participate in the process. That is the point I am making here. I hope this is making sense. I hope this is making sense to those of you watching. Please do share the broadcast. Let's hear your comments. This is what is really going on. Let's read on. So it says here, this agreement, which takes the form of a treaty, is deceptively, deviously worded to impose EU LGBT agenda on the ACP countries. This is why ACP countries must unanimously rise up and resist the signing of this agreement. Why? Because once this agreement is signed, it shall automatically override their constitutions. Understand that? Let me highlight that point for you again. You see? Because, please listen. This is why we're talking about this. Because once this agreement is signed, it shall automatically override their constitutions and national sovereignties of the ACP countries, in contrast to the Monroe Doctrine. We have to participate in our governance. It is not a question of just standing by and praying, Kumbaya, Jesus Christ, Hallelujah, Allahu Akbar. You are leaving ourselves open for the EU to continue. This is colonization in another name. This is colonization in another name. Now, let's read about Nigeria specifically. Nigeria operates the dualist doctrine under international law. Consequently, by virtue of Section 12 of the Nigerian Constitution, a treaty signed by Nigerian political leaders does not have the force of law in Nigeria until it is ratified and domesticated by the National Assembly. Are you listening? You see, we need to participate in this process, my people. We need to participate in this process. And this is what I keep trying to bring to you. We have to participate in this process. What they are doing here is to try and put in LGBT laws by the back door. We are still dealing with till today, since 1884. The Berlin Conference and the carving up of Africa and how it has destroyed and continues to exploit Africa today. And Africa is not free. And yet they are coming yet again to impose yet more injustice. Nobody is criticizing LGBT if they want to practice it in Europe. or in the Western world. Nobody. I'm not advocating for anybody to say no to it. But the imposition of this on African countries to force them into it is injustice. And we need to speak up. That's where we need to speak up. We must speak up. All of us. And I urge all of the media people to begin to share this kind of news. It is really important. We cannot allow this kind of thing to keep going. Our people, we've been, sorry, Chooks. Is anybody wants to bring me on? Hang on, did I see Chooks? You waved that. Yeah, I did, yes. So anybody want, if you want to join me on TikTok and talk about this particular issue, what are your thoughts on LGBT now that we've talked about this subject? What are your thoughts on the fact that the EU are trying to impose LGBT on African countries? Don't we have the right to say no? They are not willing to pay compensation. They don't want to admit or apologize. They don't want to apologize for enslaving Africans. They don't want to pay compensation. They don't want to acknowledge and change the unjust financial structures. Yet they want to put more pressure on us by imposing this LGBT. How do you see it? I don't know if this makes sense to you. Anybody watching, if you want to chat on TikTok, do indicate and I'll bring you on and we can talk about this from an African perspective point of view. Now, we're opening this wider to a wider audience, not just Nigerians alone, but entire Africa. So if you do want to join in, just throw me an invite and we can hear from you. And we can hear from Europeans as well. I'm happy to hear from fellow Europeans as well about this. Is this justified in Africa, where Africa has been deliberately impoverished by the direct actions of the colonials? Is it justified? Limit to go live together. Okay. I'll say hi. So invite me to go. Okay, I'll invite you. I think I've sent you an invite. I think I've sent Timmy an invite. Because these are the kind of things that is really harming us. And we cannot be silent. Going to a church, tell me how going to a church and praying in a church or a mosque will stop this kind of LGBT laws being passed on you. You need to participate in your governance. Now, Nigeria operates the dualist doctrine under international law. Consequently, by virtue of the Section 12 of the 1999 Constitution, a treaty signed by the Nigerian political leaders does not have the force of law in Nigeria until it is ratified and democratized by the National Assembly. You see that? So this is why you have to participate. Because what they will do is parachute in this LGBT law and impose it on you. Because you're saying, oh, I don't have to be involved. We need to participate in our governance and hold them to account now. Now is the time. Now, Nigeria operates the dualist. Let me put it here. Now, however, the LGBT agreement has been so craftily worded that once signed by Nigerian and HCCP countries, the agreement automatically supersedes their respective domestic laws and establishes LGBT as their new law. You have to participate in your governance. I keep saying this. People don't understand what is going on. And we are trying to raise the alarm. We are trying to raise the alarm of what is going on. This is another third wave colonization. This is now. So we had the colonization whereby it enslaved us. Now it's now about sexual colonization now. Yes, I'm going to tell me that. That is effectively what it is. It is sexual colonization. When you are trying to coerce the people who are not even free from the colonization that has carved up Africa till date, Africa is not free till date. And you are trying to now impose LGBT laws on them. Where's the freedom of expression? Where's the freedom for us to decide not to do anything like that? But you are trying to impose it on us. You see what I'm talking about. Whilst you are busy talking about prayers, Islam and Quran, you see what they're doing. That's what I keep telling us. We need to exercise and participate in our governance collectively. Let's read on. Now, so it is unbelievable that the West has elevated the barbaric act of inserting a penis into the anus or fingers or into vagina as a civilization value. The anus is meant for waste elimination. The waste comes out of the anus. However, today, West is trying to teach us of the opposite. Regrettably, the West is attempting to convince us that engaging in anal intercourse is a form of statecraft that supersedes more important matters. Exactly. People are suffering. As we speak in Africa today, there are so many wars going on in Congo, in South Sudan. in there are, you know, in Nigeria, in all over the Sahel, there are people who are funded. Those wars are funded by the West. They are funded. There are wars. People have died. There are more people dying in Africa than in the current what is going on in Gaza, as wrong as that is. And they are not putting, no emphasis is being done to it. And now they are talking about passing LGBT laws to heap more discord on Africa. You see why we need to participate in the process. You see why we need to participate in this process. And we have to begin to, we can no longer be bystanders. We can no longer be bystanders. Because this is what they are not stopping. They will not stop unless we collectively come together and put a stop to it. They will not stop. That's the point that I'm making here. I hope this is making some kind of sense to those of you watching. So let's read on again. So now, as far as the EU and the US and many parts of Europe are concerned, any country not endorsing the practice of inserting the penis into the rectum is seen as not fulfilling its international obligations. Exactly. What kind of absurdity? So they've reduced international relations to sexual relations. The LGBT countries may appear as stars that reflect light, yet they are waterless clouds carried away by the winds of eroticism, uprooted and twice dead. They resemble the fruitless trees in late autumn or wild waves of the sea casting of the foams of their vomit in public. What a shame. Where has public shame gone? For example, U.S. President Joe Biden has made LGBT rights the centerpiece of American foreign policy. This is why Biden has ordered that American flag be flown alongside LGBT flag, portraying America's LGBT-friendly country. The U.S. government is now prosecuting Uganda for enacting anti-homosexual laws in Uganda. Why are you interfering in a democratic country? Why? In his recent remarks, Biden claimed that LGBT rights are universal international law. He does not seem to understand that international law is binding upon the consent of nations. He's unaware that the consensus reached at various United Nations conferences is that the law passed in every developing country, including Nigeria and other African nations, must reflect the diverse social and economic and environmental conditions of the country while respecting their religious, cultural backgrounds and philosophical convictions. These are things that we need to be aware of. Therefore, Nigeria should not sign the LGBT agreement on November 15 or at any time. The same applies to other African, Caribbean, and Pacific countries. Instead of succumbing to the EU's veiled intimidation and blackmail to sign agreement, they should assert their sovereignty and walk out of the EU on November 15. Nigeria is a sovereign country, as are nations, African nations, the Caribbean, and the Pacific countries. We should not be dictated, though, to by the EU. We are no longer under the tutelage of our former colonial masters. If the EU decides to stop providing financial assistance due to our refusal to sign the LGBT agreement, they may proceed to do so. You see what I mean? The basis upon which the money will be lent to Nigeria, the 800 billion naira, is on the basis of them signing this LGBT into law. That is what we are trying to... Nigerian leaders not educated. Nonsense. What do you mean? You wrote nonsense. Nigerian leaders are not educated. Listen, why are they signing that into law? Kennedy, do you want to come in and talk? I can throw you. Let me throw you an invite. So I'm happy to bring you on board if you want to talk and explain what you say there. Because I'm happy to stand my ground and explain what I mean. I'm happy to discuss that. So if you want to come in, we can, you know, and discuss. Please, of course, you're welcome. I encourage you to throw me an invite and come and state your case as you see it. And let us see if that makes, if it holds water. I don't have a problem with that. But I happen to believe that many African countries, they've said no. And they can see in what we're saying, the law, it is saying that this should not happen. Now, but let's carry on. So if you do want to make a comment, like I said, in no way am I saying that LGBT is wrong. Let me be very, very clear. It isn't. Those who practice it, who am I to say that it is wrong? It is not up to me to say. In those countries that supports it, fine. But what is not right is for those countries who Turan imposed on African countries. It is totally unacceptable. And they are completely disregarding our cultural norms. I'm not saying that everything is perfect, but I'm saying if the country are not interested in that, that it should not be the basis upon which loans are lent to people. It is coercion. That is coercion. That is what I'm saying. So let's have a look again. Let's go ahead. So therefore, Nigeria should not sign, like I said. I'm just trying to read this to you here. So now it says here, if the EU decides to stop providing financial assistance due to our refusal to sign LGBT agreement, they may proceed to do so. However, we cannot yield to the EU's cheap blackmail and sign the agreement. In any case, LGBT practices are illegal in Nigeria and likely in all African countries except South Africa. The concept of same-sex cohabitation or marriage is abhorrent to Nigerian and African sensibilities. Above all, it represents a complete departure from African civilization. I have recently participated in a conference in London organized by world-class public intellectuals, renowned psychologist Dr. Jordan Peterson, and others who spoke at the conference expressed concern that Western civilization has eroded. Speaker after speaker at the conference lamented that the West has lost its history and culture and emphasized the importance of preserving one's civilization as a significant investment in this life. In the feverish pursuit of LGBT sexual pleasure and slavish freedom, the West has lost its core value and identity. Should African, Caribbean, Pacific countries join the West in this madness? No, we must stick to our own values and traditions. It is suicidal to import practices and lifestyles that are alien to Africa and seek to impose them as laws, all in the name of observing international obligations. It is obvious that the EU has no respect for the religious and philosophical convictions of the African and Nigerian people. Otherwise, it would not have been stampeding us to sign the LGBT agreement. Come to think of it, the EU lacks the local standing to seek to impose on African countries aberrations that are alien to the lifestyle of African people. Laws are made in consonance with the values of the people. Every country is interested in protecting what it holds dear or its cherished values. The EU has no right to dictate to us and the right and the kind of laws we should enact for our people. LGBT is not a value. Gay marriage is not our value. Neither is transgenderism our value. If the West is sinking to the bottomless pit of human civilization with LGBT and transgenderism, it should sink alone. It must not seek to sink together with African, Pacific, or Caribbean countries. Happily, at the time of writing, Namibia had pulled out and sworn that it would never sign LGBT agreement. It is not unlikely that other countries will follow suit and pull out of signing the agreement or signal their intentions to reaffirm from signing this agreement. In refusing to sign the agreement, Namibia said that the agreement is not in line with the Namibian constitution, its legal framework, nor its intended relations and cooperation policy. It also said that the agreement does not have definition section to ensure that all parties understand terms and agreement and what... And what they entail. According to Namibia, the agreement refers to a commitment to full and effective implementation of outcomes of Beijing and ICPD review conferences that may bind parties to future processes and outcomes that cannot be predicted at the present moment. Namibia also complains that the agreement may elevate non-binding agreements and strategies and initiatives, progress and processes to a legally binding position or treaty status. Nigeria should follow the good example of Namibia in this regard and refrain from signing the agreement. Other ACP countries should follow suit. The resolve of Namibia to exercise its national sovereignty and refrain from signing this agreement is praiseworthy. To sign the agreement is tantamount to giving EU a blank check to fill any amount of money it likes on the cash on it and cash it in the bank. Yeah. Namibia is right. The agreement is a Trojan horse. Apart from LGBT, other provisions of the agreement legalize transgenderism, human capital reduction, and queer behaviorism in the country that signs the agreement. By signing the agreement, a country consents that its children should be taught how to practice safe sex, safe abortion, and how to do masturbation, kissing, hugging, penis touching, vagina touching, and how to avoid pregnancy through sterilization and so forth. All in the name of sex education or comprehensive sexuality education, CSE. It is obvious that this agreement specifically targets children of Africa, Caribbean, and Pacific corruption and destruction. The agreement threatens to undermine the national sovereignty of Africa, Caribbean, and Pacific countries that are parties to the agreement. It is targeted at overriding their domestic laws and constitutions as well. So you see now, we need to participate in this process. What I'm telling you is something that is going to be monumentally dangerous to our existence for the coming generation. It is targeted at overriding the domestic laws and constitution as well. In the light of the foregoing, the African Parliamentarian Forum, in conjunction with African lawyers and some notable African NGOs, organized the first ever African Parliamentary Conference on Family Values and Sovereignty in Entebbe, Uganda, last year. The conference communique later gave birth to what has been christened as the Entebbe Declaration. Entebbe Declaration has not only unequivocally rejected the LGBT agreement, but has also urged the ACP government not to sign it. Annex 1 of the declaration states as follows: whereas the ACP EU Treaty Supremacy Clause invades provisions in any existing treaty with which the country conflicts, thereby also violating the national sovereignty of the countries and the integrity and regional bodies, including African Union and the integration of regional economic communities. Whereas the ACP-EU treaty violates cultural and religious values, undermines the integrity of African family values by mandating an implementation of sexual reproductive health services. And rights. SHR deceptively requiring the legalization of abortion, prostitution, same-sex marriage, especially LGBT rights, and child sexualization. Therefore, we collectively urge all heads of African ACP states not to sign the ACP-EU partnership agreement and urge their respective parliaments and legislatures, which are the national law-making bodies of the African state, to refuse to ratify this deceptive treaty. In conclusion, the EU should leave ACP countries alone in this GBT matter. Life is about living and letting live. The EU should allow ACP countries to make their own decisions. Practices like LGBT lifestyles cannot be referred to as human rights. Otherwise, deviant behaviors such as embezzlement of public funds, graft, scams, murder, theft, terrorist activities, attacks, human trafficking, and so forth could also be referred to as human rights. You may be aware that as far back as June 29, 2016, the prestigious and highly esteemed European Court of Human Rights, sitting in Strasbourg, France, delivered a historic and unimpeachable judgment on LGBTQ+. Unimpeachable judgment that LGBTQ+ is not a human right. The court, which is the highest in Europe, held that marriages entered into by people of the same sex cannot be considered as marriages. As important as the judgment is, the liberal media, such as pro-gay CNN and pro-gay BBC and others, refused to report it. Therefore, following the good example of Namibia, Nigeria, and the other ACP countries, we must not sign LGBT agreement. The truth remains that when democracies lose their constituting philosophical and legal principles, when wrongs are described as rights, and the tools of law are deployed to do and justify evil, democracies metamorphosize into LGBT totalitarianism. Sonny Ekwuusi is the chairman of the Human Rights Constitutional Rights Committee, African Bar Association. So there we have everything laid on the table. This is very important, and it ties into what I was saying about us knowing our rights. Now, many people will not know this now. They won't be aware of this. But the ramifications of what they're doing in secret will impact the lives of all Africans. Now you see why we keep telling us that we need to exercise our sovereignty. It is a must. It is a must that we begin to exercise that sovereignty and actually hold those we elect into office to account. And that is why we keep talking about this. We keep bringing in this information for us to be aware. The whole of Africa is being targeted. Please don't misunderstand me. I have no truck with LGBT being practiced in the Western world. That is part of their culture. It is part of the Greek way of life. It is part of the Greek way of life. I kid you not, there are books about this. But that is not necessarily the way of life of Africans. And the fact that they are trying to impose this on Africa is wrong. It is yet another sign of this colonial mentality that our way is right and your way is wrong. Everything about us is bad and everything about them is good. It is totally unacceptable. We must reject it. We must stand firmly with those, with all African governments, and support them. And that is why we need to participate in our governance. And we have to keep an eye on the Nigerian government, that they don't go and sign this stuff in secret. They don't go and do a midnight signing of a document and then suddenly it's passed into law. Because it can happen. We've seen it in our elections. They can do something in the middle of the night, and in the middle of the day, it's now law in our own land. We need to participate in our governance. That is what I'm saying. We need to participate and hold those we elect into office to account. What is going on now? I am saying it to the entire world. I have no problem with LGBT being practiced in Europe. Part of their culture is part of Greek mythology. It's part of their growing up in Europe. It is not part of what we have in Africa. And we have bigger problems in Africa. The poverty that Africa is suffering is as a result of colonization. We are not free in Africa. Africa is not free. 13 out of 14 countries are still being forced to use French CFA. CFA printed by France. France doesn't use CFA, but they're imposing on Africa. That is a problem that has not been addressed by EU. But now they are bringing this LGBT as an important thing. EU and America. When are we going to wake up in Africa? We need to wake up. We need to wake up, you know? Yeah, go free of them, say. Exactly. So what we are saying, I am calling on every African. And this it not only affects Africa. The Caribbean, all of the southern countries, black southern countries, we are being coerced to sign a document about LGBT. Nobody but our rights as citizens to have a better quality of life by dint of our resources are being denied on a daily basis. There are planes that are leaving from Congo every night, filled, laden with resources that should be improving the lives of Africans. The EU or the US see nothing about that. They don't see anything about that. They are only interested in heaping more confusion, bringing in things to completely diminish and destroy our own our nations, our communities, our people. We need to speak up about this. I state again categorically, I have no problem. I have no problem following, saying to people, I have no problem if you want to practice LGBT in Europe or America or Canada or, you know, Western world. By all means, it is part of your culture. I get it. But to try to impose it on Africa, it is wrong. It is morally reprehensible. And we shouldn't stand for that. And I want to thank Sonny Ekwo-Wusi, the chairman of the Human and Constitutional Rights Committee and African Bar Association. I'm going to get in touch with him. I want to play my part in this struggle. Because this is not right. You cannot. People that have been suffering under the Berlin Conference rape of Africa. Rape, RAPE of Africa. And still, till to this day, Africa is not free. And you're now going to impose sexual colonization again. Because this is tantamount to sexual colonization. What is being done here, what is being attempted here, is sexual colonization of Africa. On top of the enslavement, the looting of our resources that is still going on. Kudos to Ibrahim Traore. Ibrahim Traore has kicked out out the French from Burkina Faso. And they, you know, Niger is doing the same thing. They don't want, and these people are, they're not on, they don't want to let us breathe. Let Africans breathe in Africa. Africans are not coming to Europe to try and take things over. But but Europe is taking resources from Africa. And then they talk about immigration. You go into Africa. You go and destroy people. You take their resources. You force them to sign agreements that takes away their wealth from them. And then you then complain when they try and escape to come to your country. And is that not hypocrisy? Is that not hypocrisy? They don't want, the Western news are not going to carry this. They won't carry it. And that is why we're saying what we're saying. That it is time that we collectively begin to wake up. This is something we can't be silent about. Bolanle two forces, thank you very much. We cannot be silent about this. And I'm saying it. The Nigerian government, we need to keep an eye on them. They mustn't. We mustn't allow the Nigerian government to sign this document about LGBT as part of the agreement on which they are going to take a 700 or 800 billion naira loan from the US and Europe. We have to be awake. We have to be alert. And this is why when we say, please participate in your governance, this is what we are trying to prevent. If we are participating in our governance, the government will not dare bring this to the table because they know the people will say no. But because they're so busy, they've kept us. And that's why I keep telling you, you're putting your mind and you're going to church. Oh, I'm religious. Of what use is your religion when the government will impose laws that will override that religion? That is what's going to happen. Laws will override the EU. Once they sign the LGBT laws, it will override your belief system in Christianity. It would it's useless. I keep telling you. You need to participate in your governance. That is what we need to do. So we need to wake up. We need to participate in this process. And I do hope that many of you watching this, don't just watch it. Share this broadcast. We are raising alarm about the plan that the EU and US has to force ACP, African Caribbean and Pacific countries, to sign LGBT laws that will override their own constitutions. Who does that? You go into a country, you say we are free, and now you are trying to force us to sign LGBT laws in our own land. But yet you're the one telling us, you're kicking us out of Europe. Fine. Our resources, you're not leaving us to breathe. Let Africa breathe. Let Caribbean breathe. Let the Pacific breathe. Nobody is coming into Europe to interfere. But Europe is and US, they are interfering in the development of Africans. You see, these are things that are really, you know, I mean, I'm just trying to see if there are comments going on here, you know. So, you waved that stingy Jebu. Yeah. So, please, this is very important. On top of what we are facing, we need to be aware that if we do not take collective action and begin to participate in our governance, particularly in our local languages, I've done a program about this, I think. I'll do it in local language to raise the awareness about this because this is so, so dangerous. This is something that if we do not take heed of and take control of, we run the risk. This law, once it's signed, it will override your constitution. And we need to make sure that constitution is the one that we signed up to, not the one that's imposed on us. We have to make sure. You see why I keep saying it. We need to practice. We need to participate in our governance. So I'm going to be doing this program again. I'm going to be bringing this up over and over and over. Yeah. This is not the end at all. This is just the beginning. We need to raise the level of awareness about this. I want you to look at the bit that I highlighted there. And it's very important we understand what is going on. This cannot be allowed to stand at all. Look at that. You see? Sorry. Look at that. Look at it. Let me read that to you. Because once the agreement is signed, it shall automatically override their constitutions and the national sovereignties of the African, Caribbean, Pacific countries, in contrast to the Monroe Doctrine. This can have a huge impact on our lives, on the lives of our people back home. And yet they are telling us, oh, immigration, immigration, immigration. What is causing immigration out of Africa? Africa is being exploited night and day. There are planes flying out of Africa laden with gold, diamond, lithium, you name it, from Congo, from Nigeria, from all over, going to Europe, looted, denying the people of Africa the right to those resources. They say nothing about that. And that is the reality that we are facing. Let us call this out. I urge us all, please, this is a clarion call for every single African. On this issue of LGBT, let us say no more. Let us say we put this is the let those who are putting this forward for Africa, let it be their Waterloo in trying to impose this. The plan, in actual fact, is to completely decimate Africa. Because when this takes hold, the population will consume itself by practicing such acts that it's not something that they know. It's not part of who we are. Yes, some people may practice it, but in terms of our culture, in terms of how we do things, it is not the bedrock like it is in Greece. So I am not, let me be clear, anybody can go and show this to anybody around the world. Just so we're clear, I am not saying I am against LGBT. Just so we are very, very clear. You will not have me. Those who wish to practice that in any part of Europe or America, fine. But to impose it on African countries who are expressly saying no, that is so wrong. And the same people who are imposing it, they don't care about the impoverishment of Africans. They are the same countries. France, for example, is taking resources out of Africa at dirt cheap prices. Niger recently stopped France from taking its uranium. And it's in the uranium, France was taking Niger's uranium at 70 or 80 cents in the euro. Now that Niger has moved out of the French control, Niger is selling the uranium at 200 euros per kilo. Everything they are doing is to control. We need to be very, very clear about this, Africans. The LGBT thing here has shown now that they're trying to, again, recolonize. They're trying to recolonize. Because if somebody overrides our constitution using a new law, what does that mean? You're not free. You are bound by that law. And the people are not aware. This is why we're saying what we're saying. Please do share this broadcast. Don't you join? Thank you very much. Welcome on board. We are talking about the issue about the LGBT laws that they're about to pass, that they're trying to force Africans to sign. And we should say no. That's what we're trying to talk about. You know, I hope you find this of immense importance. Do share this broadcast. We've covered a wide range of topics. We've talked about the fact that Nigerians are suffering, and you know, there's a video whereby people have been talking about the government must do better for them. And then we talked about the need for us to know the constitution. I've gone into a lot of detail about that. But now we're now looking at the issue of the LGBT laws that the EU and US are trying to surreptitiously, covertly force African countries to sign. Now, we African countries, we must demonstrate our independence by not signing that document. We must demonstrate it, because what they're doing is very, very wrong. It is a backdoor way to colonize and override our constitutional powers, such as they are, limited as they are. And we need to make a change and put a stop to it. So, ladies and gentlemen, you are watching Citizen AY, the platform where we speak truth to power. I hope you find this beneficial. Please do share this document. Olugbedu, my brother. Hey, Gbedu, let me invite you. May I invite you? Just chat for. Let me invite Gbedu, Jari. So I've sent you, Gbedu, come on. Let's chat for a bit, Jari. So let me see. So I am happy to say it, and I say it categorically. Anybody who wishes to practice LGBT, and that's your preference, and I'm not going to go against it. What I'm against, be very, very clear, because the way they use the word, when you say anything against it, it becomes, oh, you are anti this. No, I am anti anybody imposing their own cultural belief. Because let's be clear about this. LGBT can be considered the cultural beliefs of people in Europe, Greece, and so on and so forth. We have our own cultural beliefs. Nobody has a right to to belittle our cultural beliefs as Africans. Nobody. I'm not belittling LGBT. I respect it. I say, fine. That's what, if you want to do LGBT in Europe, fine. But to try to come and impose it on Africa, when at the very time that Africa is being impoverished by the very actions of the same countries in the Berlin Conference who have carved up Africa. France today, 13 African countries are forced to use French, CFA, to use CFA that France doesn't use. That is impoverishment of the people, and nobody's saying anything. Nobody. People are being killed. There are wars going on in Africa right now that the Western media are simply not reporting. Sudan, Congo, even, you know, there are wars in the Sahel that is being funded by Western powers, but nobody's saying anything about it. And then they now come and say, you have to sign LGBT laws. Give me a break. That's not what we need in Africa. We need Africa to unite and to treat among itself and to empower its people and to stop the looting of our resources at dirty prices. That's what Africa must do. That is what Africa must do. But, I do hope that many of you watching this can relate to what is being said here. Gbedu, if you're there, do join us. Of course, you're watching Citizen AY, the platform where we speak truth to power. Help us share this broadcast. Help us reach more people. It is being watched. We're doing it simultaneously on TikTok and, of course, on Facebook. Please don't forget, I would like you to subscribe to us on YouTube. I'm going to be doing more broadcasts like this on a daily basis. And I'm probably going to be doing this program here. We need to talk about this and raise the level of awareness, because what is going on here is something that we cannot allow to happen. We have the right to freedom of expression as Africans. That is not a preserve. It should not be the preserve of Europe or US. We must begin to assert our independence. Yes, we know that the names of the countries that you called it is still under colonial name, and that's one of the things we need to break free from. This justifies why we must completely rename ourselves, go back to our ancestral belief system. Because what is being done here, Europe is trying to go back to the days of the Greek mythology and the Greek way of doing things and imposing on us. And we want us to say yes to it. Because that's what was happening. Go and look at the Greek history. Why should we allow them? They want to impose their own cultural past on us. We should say no. We have every right to say no. And we must reject it. And these are the kind of things, you know, that we need to talk about. So I wanted to know what your thoughts are and what you've heard. I'm going to come back and read this particular section again and go into detail about it. Let me read you these words. It says, this is why African, Caribbean, and Pacific countries must unanimously rise up and resist the signing of this agreement. Why? Because once the agreement is signed, it shall automatically override their constitutions and national sovereignties of the African, Caribbean, and Pacific countries, in contrast to the Monroe Doctrine. So we have to be very careful. This is what is being done. We need to reject it. Nobody, again, I'm reiterating, because I know people may cut and dash and slice something about what I've said on here. I will stand by what I am saying. LGBT, if that is considered a right in Europe by those who are practicing it, it's part of your culture. I get it. But that does not extend to you now imposing it on African, Caribbean, or Pacific countries. That is an injustice. That is unfair. In the view, the people that you are imposing this on, they are impoverished because of the very actions of the colonials. They are. That is the reality. And we need to speak to those facts. That is what I'm saying. So I'm prepared to stand on that basis. And because some people will come and start trying to throw questions. How do you're asking so all these loaded questions. I'm not interested in loaded questions. I'm interested in ensuring that Africans, our rights and our integrity, and our right to be able to decide what we want on African soil or not, remains intact. It remains intact. Because what has been done now is very, very wrong. It is totally unacceptable. And many of us are not even aware. And these laws, once it's passed, it will override our national laws. And that's the same thing in the Berlin Conference. Once they imposed, once they circled the entire Africa, no part of Africa was free. with these laws, they will do exactly the same thing. Exactly the same thing. So we need to be very, very aware. It is time we woke up in Africa and speak up against this. And we must participate in our governance. I cannot overemphasize how important that point I just made is. Ladies and gentlemen, you are watching Citizen AY, the platform where we speak to you about. If this resonates with you, please do share. Let us hear your comments. I've not been able to take calls now, but we might do later on. I'm going to have a bit of a break, and I will come back later on. Please do share the broadcast. Like I said, as far as Africa is concerned, majority of the countries, all the countries are saying they want to have, they're holding on to their cultural beliefs. For me, in Europe, part of their cultural belief is LGBT. I get it. In Greece, that was part of how they built the empire or whatever. That was how they grew. That's fine. But that does not translate to you now imposing that on Africa. We say no, or to on Caribbeans or the Pacific. We should say no. We reject it. You know, categorically, it must be rejected. So, ladies and gentlemen, you've been watching Citizen AY, the platform where we speak truth to power. Thank you so very much for watching. I hope you found this informative. Please do share this broadcast. We need to make sure that from here on, that we do not allow this injustice to continue. You know, we have to wake up and participate in our governance. And in closing, this is for Yoruba, for Nigerians. Please, to be able to achieve Biafra, Yoruba Nation, Middle Belt, we need to participate in the process of governance, to hold those we elect into office, and to be able to put in laws, referendum to allow us to be able to decide whether I want to be one Nigeria, part of one Nigeria or not. That is why it is important that we participate in our governance. Extremely important that we begin to participate in our governance. I think it's been over 2 hours now that we've been on the broadcast, and I want to thank you all for watching and joining. You've been watching Citizen AY, the platform where we speak truth to power. Do give us taps and likes and things and stars. We appreciate you all. You know, please give us thumbs up. Help us grow the platform. Help us reach more people. It is of importance that you continue to like and share the broadcast. If anything that you see on there you'd like to comment on, let's hear your comments. Even after I go for the broadcast, help us, grow the platform. Follow us on TikTok. Follow us on Twitter. Follow us on YouTube. Subscribe to us on YouTube. Of course, Facebook, Instagram, all of those platforms. We really appreciate your support. Let us help us grow. So we'll be calling it a day here. Unless I hear anybody else who wants to say one or two words, that's fine. But for now, this we need to say no. Africa must say no to the LGBT laws that the EU is trying to impose on us, because the EU don't care. They want to quickly put up the borders, immigration laws. They don't want Africans in Africa, in Europe. Fine, I get it. We get that. It's your border. It's your right. But you do not have the right to impose your cultural beliefs or norms on Africans. Leave Africa be. Leave Africa be. Leave Africa be. This is injustice. We shouldn't accept it. So, of course, I want to thank you all for watching. You've been watching Citizen AY, the platform where we speak to power. I'll be back later on, those of you who are on TikTok. Thank you so very much. We'll be back later on. Okay. So, we are off TikTok now. And we will see Afrik. Let me see. I'm trying to see what they're doing. Okay. I'm going to try and get this going. I'm sorry if I've not seen others. There's a lot of things here. So we will try and get there. Okay. In a post. Really? Okay, that's fine. Look, what I will say to you all, above all else, and in closing, there's a lot of work we need to do. Please, familiarize yourself with the Section 14.2 and 14.2c. everybody in your community. Please share this broadcast. You are watching Sizzle Network, the platform where we speak truth to power. Subscribe, hit the notification button, give us thumbs up. Let's go back. I'm probably going to do a live broadcast on YouTube as well. I seem to be having some sort of issue with one or two things, but we will get there anyway in the end. Hang on a minute. So, right, okay. So what I will say to you all in closing, please familiarize yourself with the words that I'm about to say in the Nigerian Constitution. Ijoba je ti awon eniyan Nigeria lati odo ni ijoba nipase ofin orilede igba gbogbo agbara ati ase re. Section 14(2)(a) in Yoruba. And in English now, sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria from whom the government through this constitution derives all its powers and authority. And then 14(2)(c) ikopa awon eniyan ijoba won bodo rija ju ni ibamu pelu awon ofin orilede yi. And in English, the participation by the people in the government shall be ensured in accordance with the provisions of this constitution. We need to begin to share and spread those powerful sections of the constitution to empower our people. You won't get empowerment for your community in the Bible or the Quran. The Bible or the Quran has no constitutional powers. The constitutional powers that you need, you have it as a sovereign in the constitution. Let us begin to use it together collectively. Ladies and gentlemen, you've been watching Sizzle Network, the platform where we speak truth about our Valetron. Thank you for watching and bye for now. And we'll stream it directly on YouTube as soon as we come off here. Thank you very much. Thank you and bye for now.